Well, here she is, the happy and joyous tones.
Hi.
Oh, Cheryl. Boy, you turn on that radio personality.
I am
like
so
that.
Excited today. Rob from Matchbox 20 is going to be stopping by to talk to Brian and Joe. I'm so excited. We're going to have tickets to give away for that show tonight.
Hooray!
Crowd goes wild.
We'll play Beach of the Punch today, too, so. Listen in. Brian and Joe Radio Show. Yeah! On the buzzard.
Hey, it's Brian and Joe along with our special guest, Rob Thomas in studio from Matchbox 20.
Mm-hmm. Hey, everybody.
Sold out show at the Odeon tonight?
Odeon, man. We played there once with Jacko Pierce. Mm-hmm. And we're coming back, baby. We're going to turn it out. It's just going to be a mad smashing fest. It's going to be unbelievable.
Now, what part of England are you from, Rob?
I'm from Florida. Yeah, I got rid of the band. I'm going to be doing a one-man show tonight. Yeah. I'm going to be doing it. I'm going to have, like, you know, the cymbals on my feet, and I'm going to be holding the big bass drum. And
matter of fact, you'll be playing outside the doors of the Odeon, and your guitar case will be open for any
change. Yeah,
exactly.
Actually, the truth is, I got kicked out of the band, and I'm here to vent, baby. Let me tell you something about those jerks.
Yeah, Rob, why were you kicked out of the band since we have you on our show here? First place you stopped since you got kicked out.
Because I was hitting on our drummer too much, and he couldn't handle it. Hey, I'm liking this picture of Elvis over here, by the way. But it's like Elvis meets the Crow.
Yeah, well, like, Elvis the Crow.
You know what he looks like? He looks like one of those, remember Warriors? Remember the movie Warriors? Mm-hmm. He looks like one of the guys with the baseball bats. Like, he's going to come out. Hey, man, you're going to make it back to your house, man. I'm going to stop it right here.
You know who Elvis's last hit was? The bathroom floor.
Oh, man, I knew that was coming.
Very nice, Brian. First joke of the day.
Yeah. Nice. And the second joke of the day. Come on. Bring Thunder Voice over here.
Oh, no.
Come on. Tell your joke.
Real quick, before Michael says anything, I'd like to say that the opinions expressed by Michael doesn't necessarily reflect the opinions of Matchbox 20 or WMMS.
Right. Hey, that says something about you, though. If the band kicked you out of Matchbox 20, but Mike's with you still, that must say something about your
talent. Mike's my new drummer.
Mike, come on. You got to at least say your joke. Come on. It's not that bad.
It ain't bad.
Hey, guys. You hear about Ben Hogan?
No.
Six under.
The second joke of the afternoon. Oh.
And it's just getting better and better. Hey, anybody that can think of someone else they'd like for us to offend, please call WMMS.
Yeah. All right, let's take a look at right now the tote board for jokes. So far, we've got two jokes.
Oh, that's beautiful.
As Rob turns around to look for a tote board.
Hi, listen, I'm Rob Thomas, and I'm the resident idiot here at WMMS.
All right, let's.
Yeah, we'll be honest with you. Rob was not kicked out of Matchbox 20. He was just touring Cleveland a little bit, and now he can't find his hotel.
Right. I was out last night, baby, and now I can't even find my bus, man. I don't know where it is.
We're not giving him directions until, you know, when we're done having him as a guest here on our show.
We're supposed to be in Columbus. Oh.
Let's start. Push that button, Cheryl, and we'll just continue on and keep Rob here until we finally decide to give him the directions to that hotel.
We're dimming the lights, and it's slow dance time right now on the buzzer with Matchbox 20. She said, I don't
know. The sultry sounds of Rob Thomas and Matchbox 20 on the buzzer.
Yeah, I've just heard the big announcement. Kicked from the band. The sold out. So you're not going to be able to play tonight? They're going to let you
No,
play
I'm going to do tonight.
Okay.
All right.
And
well, we got some solo stuff.
Well, you know, I mean, I'm going to do tonight. If those guys are lucky, I'll be there.
All right. Well, we have his new solo stuff. All right. Thank you. Here's new Rob Thomas for you here.
Yeah, see what you guys think of it.
All right.
I don't know if you guys are going to dig it.
I like this part. This is going to be a classic.
Buzzer. We'll talk more with Matchbox 20 lead vocalist up next.
Yeah, yeah! Zeppelin on the buzzer. The Brian and Joe Radio Show.
Now, you know, when we recorded that, I was telling them at the end, I was like, you know, I think, man, that drum thing at the end might be a bit much. And they were like, no, I think it's going to be cool. So I said, all right, fine, whatever you want.
You feel good about your decision?
Only time will tell. I've never heard of it. What it was called? Led Zeppelin? Is that the name
of the band? Led Zeppelin, exactly.
Is that what it's called? I think they're going to go pretty far.
Do we have the whole CD over there?
Yeah.
Let's just listen to the first tracks of every song.
With us in the studio, if you're just joining us, it's Rob Thomas from Matchbox 20. We found out while we were off the air that Thomas's English Muffins, actually, it's in the family. And
yeah, my mom.
He doesn't need to do this band.
Right.
Yeah, my mom actually stole that business from, she had a best friend that started the idea of the English Muffin. And so the lady that originally came up with the Thomas's English Muffin idea, like, she owed my mom $10, and my mom, like, for the interest, said, okay, give me your company, and she took it and it became Thomas. It used to be Davis's English Muffins, and that one just wasn't as catchy.
No.
And so Thomas's came on. But, you know, I don't like to talk about it because I don't.
Funny, it sure sounds like it to me.
My music is really wrong.
All right, okay. Well, hey, listen to track one. Just 10 seconds of it to see what it sounds like.
There you go.
Yeah!
If that doesn't
see,
work
right
there,
that's happy. Number
see,
two.
Right there, you know that's fun.
That yeah, just
that's
welcomes you in.
And then you go right. to this one. It's
by well, you know that one.
Now, see, that's a little more perplexed. That gets you thinking.
Right.
Now, this
right.
one here.
This is the next single.
Yeah. This is the next single. Right. Let's ready? Wait, though. Should we wait?
Yeah, let's wait
okay,
for that,
let's
one.
Get that one.
Let's go past four because
oh,
we
yeah,
already know that
play
one.
That four.
I want to push you.
Here we go. This one.
Right. Here we go.
Now, see, right there, to me, that says.
Booty and the blowfish.
On top of being excited and fun.
Yeah, right.
Yeah! Right,
next one. That tells me that Rob Thomas is a storyteller whose lyrical focus is mainly on personal relationships. And he delivers his lines with a certain intimacy, like two friends sharing a good secret. That's what that song tells me.
Wow, I can't believe we just came up with that.
Rob Thomas from Matchbox 20 in studio. We're going to track six now.
Mm. See, I'm sad already.
This is good.
I am finding the groove and becoming the music.
I like that. All right, track seven.
Oh, I hear that? That's this groove to me. Oh, this is a song called Damn.
Everybody.
No.
Everybody.
No.
Good.
Thanks.
Mm-hmm. Kyle's cooking on that one.
Oh, no. Hi, and welcome to the House of Cheese.
All right, track eight.
Okay, what do we got? What's track eight off the top of your head?
Argue Maybe.
Argue Maybe.
Let's see.
Get ready.
It's arguing.
Nice job. One thing I'll tell you about Matchbox 20 is the CD we're playing here. You go in a lot of different directions. You know, you couldn't do this with every band because you hear the same drum, boom, boom, boom. You know, what track is that? Well, it's either track 1, 4, 7, or 9. I'm not sure.
We started out with the whole idea of just starting out with the songs instead of a style, like, you know, instead of saying we're a rock band or we're whatever
right.
band. And, like, you know, like maybe 3 a.m., the song that we're going to do next is it's got, like, maybe even a country twinge to it in certain places.
Track
Can we move
nine.
On to number 9 here?
Yes.
Yeah. Ready?
Oh, this is Cody.
Is this that song?
You know if it is.
Sounds it.
You can tell, see, right off from the beginning, I'm thinking, yeah. I'm, thinking I'm sad.
You're going to tell
right
me away. Something. Cody died yesterday. All right, Ted.
I feel like someone's going to break up with me any second.
Here. See what I'm saying?
And there's, again, 47 tracks on this, collection.
No, we only taste the first 10. We only, when we do this, we only do
the first 10. Now, check out a little more of this one, because this one's like a totally.
James Bond.
But see, now, as you listen, I want you to know that it's more of a Sean Connery James Bond than a Roger Moore James Bond. It's nowhere near a Timothy Dalton James Bond. This is fun. I've never done this before. I like it.
Well, we're really honest. Sometimes we'll hurt your feelings. Sometimes, you know, we'll laugh.
I am a man of steel. Throw down number 11.
All right, here we go.
Bring it on.
Everybody, this is Last Call at the bar. Everybody, last call. Last call, everybody.
I just slept with my brother.
Who wanted this song on the album?
I did.
All right.
They're going to hit you with these peas all day.
All right, track 12.
All right, this is our last track on the
last
record.
Track.
Last track. Aww. Tell us about this last track before we
this
go.
Last track is kind of like a turn out the lights, party's over track as well. We had like maybe 4 or 5 other songs that we didn't put on the record. But like once we got it, we knew that these were going to be the 12 songs we put on there.
All right, once again, the last one. The music you're listening to is Matchbox 20. The voice you're listening to is Rob Thomas. He's a lead vocal dude from Matchbox 20.
I am the dude, by the way.
You're the dude. You did
sold
it.
Sold out show at the Odeon.
All right, here we go.
Time.
This is the last track on our record. Hey, John. What do you say we kick Clarence out of the band and steal all of his songs? The new director's gut.
She grabs her magazines. She packs her things and she goes.
See, it's sad. She's packing her things and she's going.
That's what I've learned so far.
Yeah, because...
Well, hold on. You forgot about the magazine she grabbed.
She the pictures hanging up on the wall.
Of?
She left the pictures of the naked men on her walls.
She burned
and she burned all her notes.
Notes.
Because she couldn't speak English because she was a Lithuanian grad student that just came over.
You know, this is the things we need to know.
See, I'm going to go with the album now.
Right on. Then she feels old because she hasn't got her green card. And that ages you.
All right, well, coming up, we are going to play in its entirety, 3 a.m., the third track that we skipped over purposely to keep you listening to the Brian and Joe Radio Show here.
Rob Thomas from Matchbox 20 in studio, eating beans.
Man, let me tell you, but they're not, like, bad beans. I mean, these are, like, raw
right green out of beans, the Brian, right out of the garden.
They're right out of the garden.
Right out of the Fowler Garden.
Wait a minute. Brian, is this stuff you grow into those lights in your basement?
Yeah. Oh, you shouldn't hate that stuff.
Oh. The buzzard is rocking blossoms.
Do 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 do.
Phenomenon.
Rob Thomas in studio with us here. Matchbox 20 in town tonight.
Can I sing a little song? I love Cleveland.
I love it a lot.
I love Cleveland because all the girls are hot.
Hot. Woo! What about Cheryl? Cheryl's awesome. Cheryl, after seeing you, listen to the album, but she wants to go to the show now.
Now Cheryl doesn't, but Cheryl like wasn't attracted to me. Cheryl was attracted to John.
No, Jonathan and I are just friends.
Uh-huh.
Really?
Yeah. No, I know that. But I know how friends work.
Hey, 2 cents is the best described Cheryl.
Friendly.
She's got a little bit of something. God is better than nothing.
I got good news and I got bad news. The bad news first, darling, is Matchbox 20 is sold out tonight at the Odeon.
Oh, man!
The good news,
man.
We've got 2 sets of tickets to give away.
Right on.
All right.
Do they have to do anything special?
You tell us, man. They're your tickets.
They have to tell us what the name of number 8 was. The number 8 song on the record. We think that.
Okay, that's good. Perfect.
Did we say it?
No. Well, even if we did, I mean, then that's good. They would remember.
All right. You did say it. I threw the word maybe after it.
There you go. See? Yeah, you're right. You're exactly right.
So we're set. All right.
All right. Now tell us a little bit about 3 a.m. before we play it.
This is the third cut on this CD.
It's going to be the third single.
Third
it's 3 a.m. It's third song on the record. I wrote it. It's actually one of the only songs, like all these songs I wrote, like in the little period right before we made this record.
And obviously, it's a song you wrote at 3 a.m. Maybe.
Yeah, I wrote it. I wrote it actually about my mom.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, that's cool.
Have anything to do with muffins at all?
No.
Oh.
You need to leave my mom's muffins alone.
Right. What about the nooks and crannies we hear so much about?
You need to leave my mom's nooks and crannies alone too, mister.
Well, Rob, pleasure to have you in studio. Enjoy tonight, sold-out show,
man.
And the 2 editions. That will be coming to your show that we'll be picking right now.
At 3:35 p.m.
Oh, wow,
it's
so close.
It's time for
3 a.m. Matchbox 20 on the Buzzard.
Thank you, Rob. Love you.